طلب العلم يعني جمعتها. Some of the يعني ما نصيحتك للطالبات لطالبات العلم في هذا البلد. An advice to the female students or seekers of knowledge in this country. They get busy with so many things. يشغلنا بأشياء كثيرة ولا يستطعنا الرحلة إلى بلاد المسلمين لطلب العلم. So they cannot seek knowledge. What is your advice for them to raise their, you know, ambition, their aspiration? ما نصيحتك لهن لرفع الهمة في العلم؟
نعم. النساء الأصل أنهن شقائق الرجال.
The principle regarding the women is that they are the twins of the men. You know, they are just their sisters.
وقول الله تبارك وتعالى يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات يشمل الرجال والنساء.
The statement of Allah Ta'ala that Allah truly raises those who believe amongst you and those who have been granted knowledge. Allah raises them in so many levels and degrees. This is inclusive of men and women.
وأيضا قول الله تبارك وتعالى إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء يشمل الرجال والنساء.
Likewise, the statement of Allah Ta'ala that there only fears Allah from His servants, the scholars. This inclusive of men and women.
وكذا قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة.
Likewise, the statement of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم that the one who treads a path seeking knowledge, then Allah will make an easy way for him to paradise. Also includes both.
ولا شك أن الرحلة في طلب العلم مهمة جدا.
And there is no doubt that taking a journey, traveling to seek knowledge is very important.
ولكن ليست هي كل شيء.
But it is not all there is.
فإمام دار الهجرة.
The Imam of Dar al-Hijra, the place where Rasulullah
which Rasulullah
mentioned about him that it is about time that the people will travel to him to seek knowledge under him.
الإمام مالك بن أنس.
And that is Imam Malik ibn Anas.
لم يرحل في طلب العلم.
He never traveled.
ومع هذا شد الناس الرحالة إليه في طلب العلم.
Yet the people actually they were the ones who traveled to him to seek knowledge.
فالنساء يمكنهن طلب العلم دون الرحلة.
So the women they can seek knowledge without traveling.
خاصة الآن مع تيسر السبل ولله الحمد والمنة.
Especially nowadays when those many means have been facilitated for seeking knowledge.
فتستطيع أن تطلب العلم عن طريق الأشرطة والكتب والإنترنت وغير ذلك.
Seek knowledge through the audio tapes, internet, and other than that.
وأحيانا تحضر درسا على الهواء مباشر وتشارك.
And sometimes she can attend a lecture live and she can also participate in that lecture.
فمن كانت جادة منهن في طلب العلم.
The one who is serious amongst them in seeking knowledge.
فلتتذكر قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Then let her remember the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما.
Whoever takes a path or threads a path to
سهل الله له به طريقا.
A way to seeking knowledge, then Allah عز وجل will make an easy way for him to paradise.
وهذا طريق في طلب العلم.
And this is a way to seek knowledge.
ولتحرص على الحفظ قدر ما تستطيع.
Let her be keen and diligent to memorize as much as she can.
والتكرار.
And to repeat.
ولعل الفراغ الذي تجده في بيتها.
And maybe the free time that she has in her home.
وانشغال الرجل في طلب الرزق.
And the fact that the man is busy earning his sustenance.
فهذه فرصة عظيمة لها لتقدم على طلب.
This is a great opportunity for her to embark upon seeking knowledge.
مع الحرص على أن تتلقى العلم الصحيح من العلماء الثقات.
Alongside with her being keen and diligent to seek the knowledge, to receive the knowledge from the scholars who are trustworthy.